All right, so I got everything buttoned up in the front. I'll show you guys real quick. I'm closing up shop right now, and I'm gonna tackle this another day. I ran out of time just trying to figure everything out and how to seat the seals and shit. I don't know if I did it right or wrong. I don't know. I guess I'll show you guys when I actually do it. But got everything up, got the seals in. I just have to get new snap ring pliers. That's it. I'm gonna order like a good set of them, but I got everything else on. This is all tight. I'm missing one nut on the back side. I don't know where the hell the nut went, but it's pretty much really tight, so it's good to go there. I got all this stuff tightened down, good to go. Axle seated, the seal is seated in here. I'm probably gonna take this one off, this ABS sensor. I'll just run the one that's on there now and keep this as a spare. I gotta get this back on, which is a locking hub. And then I'm gonna go ahead and order new rotors, new pads. I wanna do those all the way around. But I'm gonna go ahead and lock up the shop real quick. And I'm gonna come tackle this probably not tomorrow. Today's Saturday. I'm probably not gonna do it tomorrow because I gotta get those snap ring pliers. I'll probably pick this video up the following weekend. I am going to be burning some leave just so I can get this truck fully squared away. We still have a lot to do on it. I still got some speakers that I gotta do and whatnot. And so by the time you see this next clip with some editing magic, it's been probably about a week or so later. You guys are seeing it within a millisecond. All right, so it is actually another day. We are heading back to the shop. We're gonna do the other side hubs and axle seals. They're not leaking on the passenger side, but I'm just gonna do them anyway. I'm still nervous that they're gonna start leaking on the driver's side because I did not replace their inner axle seal. You have to pull a whole diff apart, and I just don't feel like doing that. I'll let a shop do that. But nonetheless, we're gonna go do that, and I'll explain all the other stuff that I'm actually still getting in that I bought for the truck to kind of get it squared away and ready for its long ass journey. Oh, I'm in the shop. Got everything kind of off right here. Not everything, but you know, the wheel, the lock and hub piece off. Oh my god. Everything's kind of on over here. I don't have everything on, but it's pretty much just squared away. I'm missing one snap ring. It's kind of foobarred, so it's not snapping in. I wasn't actually going to do this side, mainly because it's not leaking, but when I took a closer look, you can see, yeah, she's a little floppy girl. So I might as well just replace it. I'm hoping this snap ring comes off a little bit easier. I do have a better snap ring pliers. They're more of a solid one instead of sprung ones. So I'm gonna get cracking on this, set you guys up on a tripod, and probably just time lapse me removing everything. Holy shit. Give me one second. I'm gonna shut the camera down. Good fucking God. That was a bitch. I finally was able to get it out. I had to hammer this thing up because it was actually in like 3 or 4 different pieces. So I had to like hammer it off. Once I got it to push forward out, axle came right out. So here's the axle. As you can see, this thing is roached. Finally got everything off. I must have went through about, I don't know, 6 pairs of gloves. They kept tearing and whatnot. So I'm gonna go ahead, pull the knuckle off, press the ball joints out, press the new ones in, then press the new seal on the inner or outer, I guess you could call it, the outer side of the shaft near the U-joints. Then press the dust shield on. Once I press the dust shield on, I should be able to slap everything back on. This side's not that dirty, so I'm kind of just gonna spray it down real quick. Not really go through the motions of cleaning the whole thing. Put everything back on and I should be good to go. It does not take that long to do this. The driver's side took me, I think, 30 minutes to get everything dismantled. And this side was a little more difficult because the actual steering links connect into a point. So it was difficult to lift the steering links out and it was just a lot of planning. But as you can see, this is part of the dust boot or dust shield. Let me bust out the new hub, start cleaning off this knuckle. I'm gonna sand down the axle shaft that's kind of rusty. I'm gonna use a very, very fine sandpaper, sand it down, clean it up, clean that whole thing up, slap some grease on there, lube them bitches up, slide them on in. We finally got it off. This thing, I mean, you can see how mangled it is once I focus. You can see how mangled it is. This was like pretty much seized onto the axle. This thing is like trashed. So I'm gonna have to clean this up, sand this all down, because the new seal, I don't want this to be sitting with all this shit on it. Like I said, I'm gonna sand this down, clean this whole axle tube up, and then press the seals on. I'll show you guys real briefly how to press them on. They're pretty easy. There's no, you just hammer them on and you're good to go. Yeah, that's not supposed to be like that. I'm gonna get these swapped out real quick. There's millions of videos on how to do it, probably better than I would, but you know, I'm not a professional diesel mechanic. Schmutz on my head. Well, just like that's all done. I repressed the the outer axle seal. You press the dust seal on afterwards, so you don't want to lube up the actual part that's going into the diff and hubs assembly. Not the hub assembly, I'm sorry, I'm just really tired right now. The part of the axle that goes towards the diff, you don't lube that up because that's where the actual gear oil is going to be on. You do lube up the other side, what that's going into the hub. You want to lube that one up. You don't really want to lube the ball joints up. You want to grease them up. So I haven't greased any of these yet, so I probably won't drive the truck until I get grease. I keep forgetting to buy it. We're going to go ahead and plop all this stuff back on. No, I'm not really going to go through the process of cleaning and painting. I don't want to do all that. Again, this truck is just a tow truck. It's not going to be a daily driver. All that other stuff, if I paint and everything, that's all going to be down the road. Way down the road. Okay, enough babbling. Let me get this knuckle on. Once I seat the knuckle and I secure everything, I can slide the axle on and I will show you guys putting hub on, the dust boot, dust shield, and the dust seal. We'll say that, dust seal, which I do have the tool to actually press it on. Alright, so she is down, back on the ground. I am not putting the front bumper on yet. That is staying off until I am 100% done. As you can see, this thing is filthy. I gotta clean it. For the most part, everything's on. This castle nut goes on that link right there. It wasn't going on, so we're gonna hold on to this and we're gonna clean this up. I might have to get new steering links. If that's the case, I'm just gonna upgrade them. I do have to change out the front leafs. I still have the new ones sitting over there, so I gotta change out those. I gotta change out these brackets on the front mount, the rear shackle. I want to do the struts and the shocks all the way around. And a couple of things I really want to go over with you guys. Sorry about the mess. None of this is mine. Another thing I got for the truck are these, just some inexpensive speakers for the doors. I don't need subs and all that crazy shit. As long as I can hear my music, I don't need the world to hear my music, and I really don't like extreme bass. That shit is annoying, and it just doesn't sound good to me. But I'm gonna swap these out for the doors in the doors another day. There's just shit everywhere. I gotta come in here and I gotta clean because, because I do. But I am going to end this video right here. I'm sorry, it's been boring. I don't have a fun car right now. I was thinking about doing a fun car or getting another fun car to start a project, but I have nowhere to put it. It is what it is. Nothing I can really do for now. We'll keep pressing forward. Super's almost done. Evo has been painted. I don't know if they cut the paint yet or not, but the Evo I think is pretty much done. So we're just waiting on that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video anyway. I don't even know what to say. I really got nothing. I need each and every single one of y'all to stay hungry, stay humble. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Later. I swear to God, man, I'ma make it soon. Silence all the haters as they see us making moves. I do what I want, so I got nothing to prove. Staying motivated, teaching others what to do. I'm staying focused, my mind is open. They start to notice that I'm in